Once upon a time, there was a little girl with an adorable red cape and great flaming eyebrows.
Samurai Jack is one of those Cartoon Network shows that will forever live in the Hall of Fame. For many kids who watch the network outside of Toonami, Samurai Jack was their first real taste of action on the network. The show invoked real, brilliant storytelling, crafting shots to look very cinematic. And a lot of the series was nonverbal, choosing carefully and methodically when to use its dialogue and when to use ambient sounds, or even let music tell the story.
Once again, I am free to smite the world as I did in days long past. Long ago in a distant land, I, Aku, the shape-shifting master of darkness, unleashed an unspeakable evil. But a foolish samurai warrior wielding a magic sword stepped forth to oppose me. Before the final blow was struck, I tore open a portal in time and flung him into the future, where my evil is wrong. Now the fool seeks to return to the past and undo the future that is Aku.
The series in its original run was highly episodic, allowing viewers to pop right in any moment. The world building is pretty straightforward, allowing you to see the pure destruction and aftermath of Aku's wrath. Swinging from high tech and futuristic to nomadic and tribal at a drop of a dime. Samurai Jack is an American animated action-adventure television series created by Genndy Tartakovsky for Cartoon Network. Tartakovsky conceived Samurai Jack after finishing his work on his first cartoon, Dexter's Laboratory, which premiered in 1996. Samurai Jack was inspired by Kung Fu, 1972 television drama starring David Carradine. You know, Bill from Kill Bill.
Baby, you ain't kidding.
And Tartakovsky's fascination with samurai culture. Premiering on August 10, 2001, Samurai Jack originally ran for 4 seasons, comprised of 13 episodes each until September 25, 2004, without including the overarching story. The show made its debut in a 3-part premiere involving Jack's origin and the birth of Aku. The show was revived 12 years later for a darker, more mature 5th season that provided a conclusion to Jack's story. Premiered on Cartoon Network's Adult Swim as part of the Toonami programming block on March 11, 2017, and concluded with its final episode, which served as series finale on May 20th, 2017. Each episodes were directed by Tartakovsky himself in collaboration with others. The series was so legendary that it gained critical acclaim and won 8 Primetime Emmy Awards, including Outstanding Animation, as well as 6 Annie Awards, which is a pretty big deal. Samurai Jack tells the story of an unnamed young prince, voiced by Phil LaMarr, from a kingdom set in feudal Japan, whose father was given a magical katana from 3 gods, those gods being Ra, Rama, and Odin, so that he can use it to defeat and imprison a supernatural shapeshifting demon named Aku, voiced by Mako, and later Greg Baldwin, season 5. 8 years later, Aku escaped and took over the land and held the emperor hostage, but not before the prince was sent away by his mother to travel the world and train so he could return and use the magic sword to defeat Aku. On his return, however, the prince became a samurai and defeated Aku with his magic sword. The crime But before delivering the final blow, Aku opened a portal in time and flung him into the future, anticipating that he would be able to deal with the samurai by that time. The samurai prince arrives on an earth surrounded in dystopian retrofuturism ruled by Aku. The first people he encounters call him Jack as a form of slang, which he then adopts as his name. His given name is never mentioned. Jack only has his kimono and his sword. It's really interesting to note that one of the dogs that he meets also appears in Craig McCracken's Powerpuff Girls. So that's a neat little crossover. Most episodes depict Jack overcoming various obstacles in his quest to travel back to his own time and defeat Aku. And his quest is usually prolonged by occasional moments where he almost nearly succeeds and gets to go back to his own time, but reluctantly has to help the people who are being undermined by Aku.
My baby! My baby! Oh, thank you, kind sir. I thought I'd never see my precious again. There, there, baby. Mama's got you now. Precious? What is it? What have you done to my baby?
I am afraid your son has seen many things on our travels and has now achieved Sakai, the spirit of the samurai.
So Jack is a hero with a heart of gold, and sometimes it acts as a good kick in the teeth. And that's something charming about Jack, you know? He's a very humble and reserved guy, but also a guy that loves to stick his neck out for the little guys. It sucks that the world around him hates him. The setting of the show revolves around retrofuturistic worlds inhabited by a variety of different denizens, including robots, extraterrestrials, talking animals, monsters, magical beings, and deities. Some areas may be very technologically advanced that have something like flying cars, while others have ancient and almost semi-industrial conditions. Moreover, Aku has brought aliens from other planets to inhabit the Earth, which is interesting considering he comes from space. So, is he a demon or is he an alien? Criminals and fugitives of all kinds are very common in this world. Mythological and supernatural creatures make regular appearances and coexist amongst the technologically advanced inhabitants. However, the planet has hardly been urbanized by a number of episodes that take place in uninhabited areas of the world. That includes forests, jungles, mountains, and largely untouched lands even Aku has yet to fully conquer. There are even communities that haven't even been affected by Aku's dominance, such as the Shaolin monks, who have managed to hide and maintain their numbers in a secret place as magically shielded from Aku.
Samurai Jack will return on Cartoon Network. Samurai Jack now returns on Cartoon Network.
Let's talk about my favorite episodes. Some of the standout episodes for me have to be Season 4, Episode 1, Samurai vs. the Shinobi. Jack comes face to face with a ninja who is a master at blending within the shadows. And it's an interesting fight because you get to see how Jack's mind works when he comes up with an adversary who is just as smart or maybe even smarter than him. Next, we have Season 1, Episode 8, Jack vs. Mad Jack. It's the typical, oh, the protagonist needs to fight a dark version of himself. And it's really cool to see Mad Jack, especially considering that Mad Jack might be the same Jack that we see later down the line. Although one Jack is a figment of his imagination and the other one is magical. Next, we have season 1, episode 11, Jack and the Scotsman, where we get introduced with my third favorite character of the show, Scotsman, Jack's best friend, who is the complete opposite of Jack, loud, boisterous, and completely proud, and loves his wife.
Shut it! You're all tone deaf! A banshee can at least carry a tune! The sound of breaking glass has more rhythm! I've heard pigs squeal better than you! You call this singing? Now my wife, she can sing. Her angelic voice floats such melodious and heavenly tunes, it makes angels weep. The sun rises just to hear her moaning melodies. Even the sweetness of birds can learn a thing or two from my precious bonnie lass. My wife's been kidnapped!
You are married?
Aye, to the most beautiful bonnie lass that ever blessed the ground with her footstep.
Let's go home.
Oh, angel. Oh, my buttercup. You are grand. My wee life would be a darkness without you.
You're sweet talking me.
Aye.
Don't ever stop, love. Don't ever stop.
Oh, darling. Oh,
you're a sweet man to come rescue me.
Yo, you straight?
Yeah, I'm good. No, I'm good.
Dog, we literally on there like me, Odell. We got...
Oh, it's been a long fight. It's been a long fight, and I just had to have a warrior spirit, and that's all. So I'm just...
Don't start that.
No, I'm good. I'm just regrouping.
He's played excellently by John DiMaggio, the voice of Dr. Draken, Jake the Dog, and Bender, just to name a few characters. And he's one of those characters that probably has the most reoccurrence alongside Jack and Aku. And lastly, we have season 1, episode 13, Aku's Fairy Tales. Aku tries to make children hate Jack by telling stories about him being an evil villain, with Aku making the children love him, with stories about him being a hero. And we get the birth of my favorite scene in all of Samurai Jack, about him retelling the story of Little Red Riding Hood. The original series was left open-ended after the conclusion of the fourth season. In season 3, episode 32, Jack is in search of a time portal, and we get ominous foreshadowing about him being the chosen one. Jack must face the guardian of the time portal, voiced by my man, Kevin Michael Richardson.
Is the passage through time that I have quested for?
Yep.
I humbly request your permission to use this great power.
Nope.
The Guardian reveals details about how several warriors have come to face him, but none has succeeded. Only one is destined to defeat him and go through the portal. The Guardian defeats Jack, but is stopped from killing him as the portal speaks to him. Afterwards, we get to see a possible future involving Jack, where he's a warrior king, a la the style of Conan the Barbarian, which makes sense because Gendy really likes Conan. Duh, he hired Mako. But keep this in mind for later, as we will circle back to this.
Deserve more credit and respect!
I've always found a cure, but you can't find one else. But now I know I've got to find it for myself.
legend continues, weeknights at 10 on Cartoon Network.
After four seasons, Samurai Jack ended abruptly. A film was intended to conclude the story of Samurai Jack, which was in development several times by four different studios. As nearly as 2002, Cartoon Network was producing a Samurai Jack live-action feature film with association with New Line Cinema and having Brett Ratner hired as the director. Brett Ratner, you know, the guy that gave us Rush Hour? I don't know how that would have worked. In 2006, Gendy said that live-action Samurai Jack was thankfully abandoned and that we will finish the story and there will be an animated film. 2007, Fred Seibert from the newly company formed at the time, Federator Film, was developing a Samurai Jack movie, which was planned to be in stereoscope 2D with a budget of nearly $20 million. Seibert said that in 2009, the film was being co-produced with J.J. Abrams and his studio Bad Robot Productions. The feature film was never materialized, and eventually the series would conclude with a fifth season. Samurai Jack returned to our television screens nearly 12 years later after its fourth season concluded, with the first episode airing on Adult Swim on March 11th, 2017.
50 years have passed. Aku's grasp chokes the past, present, and future. Hope is lost.
Hope lives. It is everywhere.
You are worthy.
After years of hunting Aku, Jack's journey is almost over. But what awaits him at the end of his long road?
Together, we're going to defeat Aku.
Samurai Jack!
Aku!
There are only two ways out. Victory or death.
Sweetheart, you have to bring out your best to defeat him.
Samurai Jack, the final episode, next Saturday night at 11 p.m. Only Toonami on Adult Swim.
During its time away, the animation industry made a huge shift from cel-drawn animation to digital, combining the likes of 3D seamlessly into the production, increasing the production value by introducing techniques such as lighting, shading, and vibrance. Shifting away from its 4:3 aspect ratio to 16:9 with the advent of 1080p, making everything look crisp and clean. Almost every still frame can be a poster. Season 5 shifts away from the episodic nature of the series to more serialized storytelling, where Jack was more of a static character, often affecting the world around him in the previous seasons. Season 5 makes our samurai grow and evolve and deal with the pain of being a lone warrior on a mission to defeat evil. The show is darker and deals with more mature subject matter, not afraid to tackle subjects such as brainwashing, self-harm, and dissociative identity. The effects of time travel have left Jack effectively immortal. Coupled that with his loss of his sword, we see a Jack who is despondent to the world around him. He's lost, but still willing to fight if the situation arises, guilt-ridden by all the lives he's failed to save. It's through Aku's machinations that we see that the world has come to either hate Jack or see him as a savior. And in the cases of the daughters of Aku, they see him as a destroyer that needs to be vanquished. Throughout season 5, Jack is faced with dealing with a new enemy turned love interest in the form of Ashi, brilliantly performed by Tara Strong. He's one of those daughters of Aku that I mentioned earlier and was raised from birth to destroy Jack. It's interesting to see Jack through her point of view, how she comes to realize he was completely wrong about him. Her relationship with Jack starts off antagonistically, but eventually they learn to work together with each other and bring out the best in each other. The show ends on a Gurren Lagann style moment where Jack finally defeats Aku with the help of all the friends he's made along the way. But at the final moment during Jack's wedding, the ramifications of defeating Aku means Ashi would never be born, and thus she fades from existence as Jack looks forward towards the future. Produced by Cartoon Network Studios and William Streets, you know, the one that made the sound in the middle of the night that sounds like this. Tarkovsky served as executive producer for the fifth and final season, which dealt with more mature elements and a cohesive narrative that concluded Jack's journey. The story takes place 50 years after Jack was last cast into the future, and in his despair from the years of fighting Aku and Aku's destruction of the remaining time portals, Jack was not allowed to age as an effect of... Remember the Time Guardian that I was talking about earlier? Well, sucks to be that guy, because despite the prophecy, when Jack arrives to the Guardian's lair 50 years later, the portal was destroyed like all the others, and the Guardian's red glasses were the only thing that withstood the damage. It seems that even the Time Guardian was no match for the Master of Darkness himself. It's unknown how the past Aku's destruction affects his existence, but as he has guarded his portal for countless of eons, very likely that he's still alive in the past and will continue to guard his portal. Jack is haunted by a warped version of himself and of his family, and by crazy deadly warrior on horseback, clad in armor. Phil LaMarr reprises his role as Jack. Greg Baldwin provides the voice of Aku. He was also the stand-in for Aku after he passed during Avatar. So, he's not that bad, because, heck, I didn't notice it when watching Avatar The Last Airbender. You kind of notice it now during Samurai Jack, but it's not too distracting.
Came the voice of Samurai Jack through the most ordinary circumstances possible. I auditioned. I wish there was something. Well, we met on the top of the Himalayas, and we looked at each other and knew there was something special, but 10 years later, we've came together to do this project. Now, it was regular old showbiz.
Working with Phil LaMarr, who does the voice of Samurai Jack, is great. You know, when I hired Phil, he gets it. He understands it. You know, he can read the storyboard and know where Jack is at. Because we're doing all this more emotional, more deeper character stuff, he's taking it to kind of that next level, you know.
What do I like most about voicing Jack? It's the easiest job in show business. He says like four lines. Then there'll be like some other guy's like, well, let me explain the whole plot of the story. And I just go, I see, I will find it. And then I'm done.
I'd say my favorite character to write for is Aku, of course. The original series, Mako brought so much great energy to him.
Who dares to summon the Master of Masters?
Not only is he demonic, but he's the most hilarious character in the whole universe. So it's been a lot of fun being able to get back into him and seeing how he's changed in this series.
I mean, Mako's passing was hard. I thought about first changing his voice to something completely different, you know, but Aku is so special and his voice was such a part of it, I didn't want to kind of reboot him, you know. So we got a guy who does a pretty good imitation. I mean, look, I'll be upfront, but nobody can replace Mako 100%.
The legacy of Samurai Jack spans far and wide, allowing him to cross over and be in stuff like CN Bumpers or having cameos in stuff like Duck Dodgers. Even going as far as to have a comic book published by IDW produced from 2013 to 2015. having appearances in several media such as video games with the likes of Samurai Jack, Amulet of Time, for the Game Boy Advance in 2003, Samurai Jack and the Shadow of Aku for the GameCube and the PlayStation 2 in 2004. 3 years after the series was completed, a third game, Samurai Jack Battle Through Time, was released on August 21st, 2020 for Windows, Microsoft, PlayStation 4, Xbox One, Nintendo Switch, and Apple Arcade. Elements of Samurai Jack's concepts were reused in other Cartoon Network games such as the MMO Fusion Fall, which features Jack the Scotsman and Aku as a Nano. The brawler game Cartoon Network Punch Time Explosion for the Nintendo 3DS, Wii, PlayStation 3, and Xbox 360, Jack and the Scotsman as playable characters, with Aku as an assist, a boss, and a playable character. As for today, my biggest wish is that we get to see Samurai Jack appear in Warner Brothers Multiverses, because Lord knows that game deserves to have a character like Jack. Ultimately, Jack will forever be goated as one of the best shows Cartoon Network's ever produced. And it's as close to cinema on a small screen as we're ever going to get in terms of animation. And I love it. But if you agree, disagree, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. And if you want to watch Samurai Jack, you gotta do it soon before it's eliminated from HBO Max. So go do that soon. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you know the next time we upload. And thanks for watching. Peace.